Good morning, viewers. It's a new day. Welcome to today's devotion with the Daily Fountain, the devotional guide of the Church of Nigeria Anglican Communion. Invite your family and friends, get your Bible and your Daily Fountain manual while our devotional leader takes us on today's devotion.
Good morning, viewers. You're welcome to Daily Fountain Devotional of the Church of Nigeria Anglican Communion. Today, Friday, 17 December 2021. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for today. Today you have made, and we give you all the glory. We thank you for your word. In the entrance of your word gives light. We pray that as we share your word today, in this time of devotion, may we be blessed in every way. And may we get that which you have promised for us through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Our topic today is He Delights in Mercy. And our text will be taken from Micah chapter 7, verses 11 to 20. And I read, "In that day when your walls are to be built, in that day the decree shall go far and wide. In that day they shall come to you from Assyria and the fortified cities, from the fortress to the river, from sea to sea, and mountain to mountain. Yet the land shall be desolate because of those who dwell in it, and for the fruits of their deeds. Shepherd your people with your staff, the flock of your heritage, who dwell solitarily in the woodland, in the midst of Carmel. Let them feed in Bashan and Gilead, as in the days of old, as in the days when you came out of the land of Egypt. I will show them wonders. The nations shall see and be ashamed of their might. They shall put their trust, their hand over their mouth. Their eyes shall be deaf. They shall lick the dust like a serpent. They shall crawl from their holes like snakes of the earth. They shall be afraid of the Lord our God and shall fear because of you. Who is a God like you, pardoning iniquity and passing over the transgression of the remnant of his heritage? He does not retain his anger forever because he delights in mercy. He will again have compassion on us and will subdue our iniquities. You will cast all our sins into the depths of the sea. You will give truth to Jacob and mercy to Abraham, which you have sworn to our fathers from the days of old." This is the word of God. Mercy is a compassionate forbearance to someone who ought not to have been shown any mercy. It is a magnanimous disposition to one who ought to have been punished for an offense. When there is no mercy, there is justice and retribution. Our passage today is stressed in a great way God's benevolence towards Israel, his own people. And our passage is stressed in a wonderful way the very nature of God, one who delights in mercy. Preachers of several ages have painted the picture of an angry, bloodthirsty God who will not spare sinners in any way, but will unleash merciless and judgment on their sins. This is not the true picture of the God we serve. He is abounding in mercy and steadfast love. The scripture states that all have sinned and come and fall short of the glory of God. The wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. In our text, Micah prophesied to a world that looks like ours. He condemned the spate of violence, cruelty, injustice, oppression. He condemned disobedience, among all others. In our text, God promised that he will rebuild the walls of Israel. He will save Israel from their enemies and from the invaders. Verse 12 says, in the day the Lord shall come from Assyria and the fortified cities, and from the fortress to the river, from sea to sea, and the mountains to mountains. God, in his mercy, has decided to show mercy to his people despite their sin. The prophet prophesied hope for the remnant. This hope is shown in several ways. Firstly, God promised in his word that he would pardon their iniquity. Pardoning iniquity is not as easy as that. It's the very nature of God, who is so loving and benevolent. He promises absolute pardon. Brethren who are listening to me today, though your sins may be as scarlet, God has promised in his word that he will make them as white as snow. He also promised passing over the transgression of the remnant of his heritage. He will no longer reckon their sins. He will blot away their sins and pass over their iniquity. Brothers and sisters, despite the level of how we have degenerated in sin and gone out of God's way, he still delights in mercy. He promised also in our text that he does not retain his anger forever. Retaining of anger means ensuring that no sin goes unpunished and venting his just indignation on unrighteousness. But the God we serve has promised that his anger, which is just as a result of our sins, will not be retained forever. Hallelujah. Because the blood of Jesus cleanses us from all sin. And again, he promised to have compassion. Compassion is a very wonderful nature of God, which is connected to his mercy. Compassion is to suffer with someone, to appreciate the situation. And the scripture did say that we have a high priest who is able to sympathize with our weaknesses, even Jesus Christ, the righteous. What a wonderful show of boundless mercy to people who are not qualified in any way. He continued to promise and to stray and explore in a great way the very nature of God, because he delights in mercy. This is to state that he is not happy when he is not showing mercy. Mercy is his very nature. Mercy comes from within him. Mercy is his second name. And he likes, and it is his own privilege, to extend that prerogative even to those who never benefited it and who are not supposed to get it. So my brothers and sisters, even when we have gone far into sin, into addiction, into immorality, into oppression of the poor, into despicable violence, into kidnapping, and whatever we may call it, that is a sin, God delights in mercy. He will have compassion and subdue our iniquity. He will cast all our sins into the depths of the sea. Hallelujah. Casting our sins into the depths of the sea is a way God has promised Israel to deal permanently with their sins. As their sins are cast to the depth of the sea, that means that their sins are thrown away and forgotten. And that means that before the presence of God, they are found guiltless. What a wonderful Savior who delights in mercy. He will give truth to Jacob and mercy to Abraham. Jacob happens to be the ancestor of Israel, God's own people, who through cunning way obtained the promise which was also made for him. And he also made the brother to sell his birthright. But he said he would give truth to Jacob and show mercy to Abraham. Abraham is the father of faith, who followed God even in old age. And when he followed God, God promised him mercy. And God also promised him in the covenant he made with him that he would give him his descendants and will make them multiply and give them the promised land. And this mercy he has won to Abraham and to Jacob from the days of old. Mercy is shown in several areas in the scriptures. The Bible did say that the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercy never comes to an end, but they are new every morning. Lamentations 3:23. Blind Bartimaeus recognized the mercifulness of God, the mercy which Christ shows to those who do not deserve it in any way. God's mercy is epitomized in Christ, who came and went all the way to the cross just because of a God that delights in mercy. And blind Bartimaeus, upon hearing that Jesus was coming to the city, shouted, "Son of David, have mercy upon me." Have mercy upon me typifies, extend this benevolence to me. We do not know of a certainty whether he was asking for alms, as beggars will do, or he was asking for healing. But something we knew, that all he required from God is mercy, mercy, and mercy to a God that delights in mercy. Children of God, today we have come to realize in a more special way that God is merciful. And he has given us this provision of mercy through the death of Jesus. And in a season like this, as we celebrate his birth, it's all about the echoes of mercy, of a God who delights in mercy. In our celebrations, in our neighborhood, as we travel far and near, and we celebrate in all kinds of feasts that unites us and our families together, let us remember that God delights in mercy. Let's, first of all, ask and crave for the mercies of God. We need the mercies of God in a country like ours, at this critical point in time, when we are living in a challenged situation, when we have insecurity, banditry, violence, and what have you, when our neighborhood are no longer safe, and people are scared of the very communities they come from. We need the mercies of God, who delights in mercy. In our neighborhood, every day, we hear of all kinds of stories. People engaging in things that does not glorify God. They also, and we together, need the mercies of God from a God that delights in mercy. Ourselves, most of us are struggling and suffering from all kinds of bondage. And some, instead of struggling to break through from this bondage, are making it a place of comfort because we are afraid and we are laden with the guilt of our sins. But today, we are reminded in his word that God delights in mercy. The mercy of God will be extended to us through Christ if we come to him like the prodigal son who came to his senses and once said, "I will arise and go to my father, and I will say unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee. I am not worthy to be called thy son. When he came to the Father accepted the Son and showed mercy, just as a heavenly Father would do. At times like this, we must come back to God and ask for mercy in humility, in repentance, in truth. Let's come to him, the fountain of life, because there is a blood that flows from Emmanuel's vein. He delights in mercy. This is a message for this season. As we go about the celebration, God delights in mercy. He commands us to go about our celebrations in repentance, to go about our travels in penitence, doing justice, and also dealing generously with one another, extending mercy to those around us, caring for strangers and for those who are stranded, doing good as our Master, the Lord Jesus himself, did good, and making sure that this season in every way is a blessing, because our Almighty Father delights in mercy. The mercies of God will avail us as a nation, as we come to him, and as our leadership come to him in repentance and in faith. The mercies of God will avail us as a church, as we look inwards and find areas we are falling short of this mercy and ask for his mercy. Have we taken the name of the Lord in vain in recent time? Have we continued to worship God but without a pure heart? Have we, in the name of religion or worship, done things which God himself will love? The merciful God wants us to turn as a church in repentance. Have we placed issues of finance over spirituality? Have we done things that ought not to have given God the glory in recent times? God is interested in restoring us. He will restore us as a church. And to us individuals, we are reminded again that the mercies of God never ends, but rather they are renewed every morning. Every struggle without Jesus will end in futility, but for the mercies of God. St. Augustine once says, uneasy lies that heart until he finds rest in God. So we are struggling in several ways. We should come to him in mercy, asking, God, show us mercy. You who delights in mercy, give us truth. Have compassion upon us. Subdue our iniquities. Cast out our sins. Give truth to us. Show mercy to us and our children. We are sure that the Almighty God, in his grace and favor, will show mercy. We don't need to lose heart. We don't need to display a lack of faith. We don't need to doubt. But we need to keep on trusting him who is merciful, who has promised to show mercy. This mercy which was shown to Jacob and to Abraham of old. We are Abraham's children by faith. This mercy also we extend to us. For he has so much lavished the mercy through Jesus Christ, that when we are you sinners, Christ died for us. Let us respond to this mercy in a great way, knowing that he delights in mercy. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word. You delight in mercy. Have mercy upon us. heal us, heal our communities, and let your mercy speak on our behalf. As we are going about our celebration, show mercy. Show mercy upon us. Show mercy upon the church. This is our prayer. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
We thank you for fellowshipping with us today. We invite you to join us tomorrow morning, same time, same station, for another special edition of the Daily Fountain. If you are led to sponsor or support this program, please contact the numbers and email all showing on your screen. Also, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/ACNNTV. Visit our website www.acnntv.com.